So here's a nice little demonstration you can do. And it bridges the gap between an understanding of a reactivity series that contains only metals and one that contains non-metals as well. You'll need some dry ice. You can obtain it from regular cryogenic or gas suppliers, and it comes in 10 kilogram blocks like this. A regular wood saw will be able to cut through the block, but you've got to be patient because they're quite brittle. The last few centimetres will be hard going, but don't rush it too quickly, otherwise you may risk breaking the block. Cut off a lid with an inch or so to play with, and then chisel out a cavity into the body. Again, go easy with it, because you'll likely fracture the block if you hit at it with the chisel rather than scraping it. Eventually, you'll end up with something that looks a little bit like this. You can use these blocks more than once, so potentially you could actually team up with other teachers in the department and run a series of these experiments on the same day. Let's see what happens. Don't be tempted to fill the cavity too high, otherwise you can get sparks of magnesium that will fly out through the edge as you start to put the lid on.
This experiment is being performed in a fume cupboard because of restrictions where we filmed it. At school it can be done in the open lab with a safety screen to protect the audience, who should be 2 to 3 meters away, and another screen to protect yourself. The use of a blowtorch was for convenience, a Bunsen will do just as well. As with any demonstration, before attempting it you should consult your employer's risk assessment and consider whether it needs any modification for the special situation of your classroom room. Dry ice should be handled with insulating gloves and goggles should be worn. Wearing a lab coat will reduce the risk of burns from any burning magnesium that may be ejected. Never store dry ice in a sealed container or use it in a confined space. It should not be transported in the passenger compartment of a car unless the windows are open.
So there you have it. Magnesium and carbon dioxide, an unusual displacement reaction to show how carbon fits into the reactivity series.